Our Texture Coat product line transforms plain concrete into decorative works of art. Texture Coat's finishes work equally well on old or new concrete and are perfect for simulating the look of flagstone, slate, stone, pavers, tile, or create a look all your own. The Texture Coat product line includes Westcoat Stamp It, a quarter-inch polymer-modified cementitious overlay. Stamp It creates the look of stamped concrete over new or existing concrete, transforming it into a very decorative surface. Stamp It is designed for use over existing concrete substrates such as driveways, walkways, patios, garage floors, courtyards, entryways, interior floors, restaurant floors, showrooms, and pool decks. It can be installed in both the commercial and residential environments. Here's how Stamp It is installed. The concrete must be clean, dry, free of grease, paint, oil, dust, and curing agents. It should be porous, have a rough broom finish, and feel like 16 grit sandpaper. Drainage problems or puddling must be corrected prior to the installation of Stamp It. The concrete must be a minimum of 2500 PSI, 3.5 inches thick, and meet local building codes. Cut open cracks with a diamond crack chaser and remove any existing joint sealant. Shot blast or scarify the surface to create a heavy textured profile. Vacuum and sweep, then clean the concrete with a minimum of 3500 PSI or greater pressure washer. Cut open small cracks and fill with EC72 or EC74 epoxy patch. Use WP-47-3 seam tape to help reinforce the crack, then trowel EC72 or EC74 into the tape and smooth. Broadcast 30 silica sand onto the wet epoxy patch to provide a rough surface for the Stamp It to bond. This remedial approach to patching cracks is not guaranteed, and it should be noted that when its substrate moves, it could likely crack the Stamp It material. In a clean, dry container, combine EC11 water-based epoxy at a 2-to-1 ratio. Mix for 3 minutes or until completely combined. Apply the primer using a 1/2 inch to 3/4 inch nap roller evenly over the surface to be coated. Within seconds of the application, broadcast the surface with number 30 silica sand. This will aid in the adhesion of the stamp mix. Make sure not to allow the water-based epoxy to puddle as it will not cure properly. Allow the primer to cure for a minimum of 4 hours. Honor all expansion joints by identifying and tagging them using pins or concrete nails. The joints will be recut later in the process.
Combine 1 to 4 ounces of the chosen TC40 liquid colorant with approximately 4 to 5 ounces of water and 1 bag of TC6 stamp texture cement. Mix at a low RPM with a mechanical mixer until you have an even consistency.
Pour the mix onto the primed surface and spread using a gauge rake set at 1/4 inch. Smooth with a float or trowel to remove rake lines or to detail as needed. Misting water onto the surface will aid in smoothing out the gauge rake lines. A simple garden sprayer works best. Allow the mix to harden until firm enough for stamping. Your hand should be able to just slightly indent the surface. When it is firm enough, spray the surface with stamp release. Apply the release to the stamps as well. Place the stamp onto the surface and impress them slightly to create the necessary effect. Timing is everything, so use caution if you are new to this process. Continue to mix, spread, and stamp as you go, paying special attention to how fast the material is drying. The product will dry at different rates depending on the mixing, temperature, humidity, and whether or not you are working in the shade or sun. At 50 degrees Fahrenheit, stamping should be done in 3 to 5 hours after the material is poured and set with a gauge rake. At 80 degrees Fahrenheit, stamping should be done in as soon as 15 to 30 minutes. After the Stamp It is dry, locate all expansion joints as indicated by your tags or marks placed earlier. Snap lines and cut through the stamp layer to honor all existing expansion joints. Scrape and grind all edges to create a finished look. Route out all joints and perform any remaining repair or detailing of the surface and grind joints back to virgin concrete. Clean the surface by using Westcoat degreaser, mild dish soap, or TSP to remove all the release previously applied. A floor scrubber or power washer will help loosen and remove the film. Mix the SC25 accent powder of the chosen color with 4 to 10 parts water. Roll the mix onto the textured surface with a 3/4 inch nap roller and work it into the surface using a stiff brush or broom. Continue to broom the SC25 until most of the water is evaporated or until all broom marks have dissipated. Reapply to darken or accent individual stones or tiles. Mixed accent powder must be continuously stirred with a roller as the powder will settle. The darkening or accenting can also be achieved by dry rubbing the accent powder onto the surface with a dry sponge. Concrete stains such as Westcoat acid stain or Westcoat water-based stain provide an alternative method for coloring Stamp It. Please refer to the Stamp It system information sheets for more details. Westcoat offers a wide variety of sealers to varying degrees of shine and gloss, as well as mar and chemical resistance. Depending on the sealer, the seal coat may be applied by spraying, brushing, or rolling with a 1/2 to 3/4 inch nap non-shedding roller cover. For areas that require increased slip resistance, add up to 1 quart of CA30 safe grip per 5 gallons of the sealer, or broadcast silica sand into the final coating and back roll. Please read the Stamp It system specification sheet for available sealers, and read each individual product specification sheet for details on thinning and proper application. A sample should always be done to confirm gloss, build, and compatibility with the surface being coated. Allow the seal coating to cure for 2 to 6 hours before permitting light pedestrian traffic or applying additional coats. For best results, wait 24 hours before permitting direct traffic, 48 hours before placing heavy objects on the surface, and 72 hours before permitting vehicular traffic. Please refer to the Stamp It system specification sheets and individual product specification sheets for more details about drying times, material rates of coverage, and alternative finishes. For more information about this or any Westcoat product, please contact your local Westcoat distributor or representative. You may also contact us directly at 1-800-250-4519 or visit our website at westcoat.com for further training opportunities.